So I'm going to talk a little bit about converting what we have always called wastewater treatment plants into water resource recovery centers and how we might get there. So first, a little background, because most people don't know much about wastewater treatment. Back in 1914, there were the very first experiments with wastewater treatment, and it was the activated sludge system. It's a technology that's been used for about 100 years since then, and have been refined and refined and refined. The drivers for technology development in the 20th century were the ones I've listed up here: population growth, organic pollution, nutrient pollution, and especially legislation and funding with the Clean Water Act in 1972. And up till that point, mainly what was being removed from wastewater just suspended organics. After that point, we started removing dissolved organics and nutrients, and we did it with energy-intensive technology because we didn't need to have energy-efficient technologies, essentially, at that time. And then later in the 90s and early parts of this century, our focus was on removal of toxic substances, and that was largely done through upstream control of toxic emitters. In the 21st century, we have a whole new set of drivers to deal with. We have aging infrastructure. All of these 20th century treatment plants are at the end of their design life, which was 40 years. And they're put in the 70s and 80s, and we're in the end of the design life now. So they're all in the master planning process to make new systems. And we've had continued population growth, and of course, climate change now is a huge driver, huge driver. We have to think about emissions themselves from the plants. The prospects of sea level change could be appreciable. By 2050, there could be, in some recent scenarios, over a meter rise. And that would lead to potentially significant flooding at wastewater treatment plants that are close to the ocean. We also have to think about drought and floods, of course, increasingly. And eutrophication, nutrient management, residuals management is a huge problem for wastewater treatment plants, how to handle the solids that are generated, and the needs for revenue. And in order to address these issues, one thing we can focus on is, can we turn a liability into an asset? Can we turn waste into something valuable, wastewater into something valuable, recover the resources, help to offset the cost through revenues obtained that way? So if we think, what can we make and sell from wastewater, there's actually quite a bit. We can get water, which is the most valuable resource we can recover. And if you look at a cubic meter of wastewater and say, how much water can we get from it? Essentially, it's a cubic meter of clean water. And that could sell, depending on the market, 90 cents I put there as one number, and that's what farmers were paying for it last year in the drought, 90 cents per cubic meter. And if you look at the average across the United States for potable water, it's $1.50 per cubic meter last year. So that tells you the value. It's a pretty good deal, a dollar for a cubic meter, a ton of water, a dollar. And that's what its value is. But we're talking about treating tens of thousands of cubic meters per day at many of these facilities. Then we also could generate materials, which could include compost, bioplastics, and fish food, surprisingly. And we can get up to 33 cents per cubic meter with certain kinds of aquaculture-type products. This is something we've been exploring and think is a lot of promise. There's also the potential for energy recovery of information, or I should say renewable energy, to complement Mark's talk. And then lastly, information. Now, energy, of course, renewable energy should drive both these cycles for purification of water and for production of valuable materials. And then lastly, I want to say some words about information. I'll conclude with that part. So at Stanford, what we're doing is we've built a new center for resource recovery called the Codiga Resource Recovery Center. Our purpose in doing so was to accelerate the adoption of promising technologies to a scale that is realistic. And without doing this, without getting to the pilot scale, we have no credibility in this industry, zero credibility. We have to get to the pilot scale in order to have credibility. So the technology that we're featuring at this facility, it's over by the Stanford Credit Union on Sarah Street on campus, includes a compact microscreen for removal of suspended solids, a new anaerobic treatment technology that can replace activated sludge, an energy-intensive process, with a process that produces energy rather than consumes it. And it produces very little biosolids, which is a huge advantage, less than half the biosolids of existing technology. We also have it set up so that we can test modular mobile units that can tap into diverse grades of water and then upgrade it, whatever that level of quality is, to a higher level. And we're part of the National Testbed Network. It's a large network of facilities with different rankings, depending on the facility. Ours is a level 4, which is the highest level they're giving. And this is a major effort involving several agencies across the U.S. A complementary part to this that we're also focusing on is the idea of smart sewers. Right now, we spend about $14 billion a year just to fix leaking pipes, leaking sewer pipes. The Sarah Street sewer on this campus that serves the Codiga Resource Recovery Center, where we're taking water, serves about 7,000 people, including the president of the university. And so we're glad that he's a contributor. And then it, basically, this is the source of water that we use for the Codiga Center and that we test these technologies on. And we're really excited to test these technologies, of course. But in addition, it sits on this interesting sewer shed, which is old, 100-year-old clay pipes, some of which are leaking. And it also has in it then information that's useful to us. It's another facility that's on the on the same sewer is the Vaden Student Health Center. And we just got some a seed grant from the BioX program at Stanford to work with a medical school to look at the DNA and RNA of the samples that are extracted from the sewer and get information about pathogens, antibiotic resistance, and other important measures of community health. And we're very excited about that. It remains to be seen how valuable that information will be, but we believe it could be very valuable. Thank you very much.